morning, guys! Today, I will be showing you my day as a 2020 Tokyo Summer Olympics volunteer. I'm now on my way to Shiokaze Park, which is the venue for beach volleyball games. According to Google Maps, it will take me about 1 hour to get there. For those curious about whether volunteers get paid, the answer is no, we don't. We do get a 1,000 yen travel subsidy each day, but that's not quite enough to cover all travel expenses. Yay! I finally arrived at Shiokaze Park. Because of COVID-19, volunteers must wear masks throughout the games. So before meeting my team, I will change my surgical mask into this one. I did my check-in just now and I'm heading to the beach volleyball court. One thing I like best about this sport is that you get to see this beautiful scenery every day. Time to start working! One fun fact for you guys is that all volunteers here at Tokyo Olympics have a nickname, Fieldcast. And this is where all the magic happens. It's pretty sad that no spectators are allowed this year, so my job includes cheering for the athletes when they enter, arranging the sand in between games to make sure it's in good condition, and working as the ball retriever to bring back the balls. After a day of working, I'm now at the Olympic restaurant for dinner. All volunteers are allowed to have a meal here for free on the days they work. Again, because of COVID-19, plastic sheets are put up at the tables. So, itadakimasu! I'm done for the day! I don't have the night shift today, so I'm going back home. I feel it's very fulfilling to be a volunteer here at the Olympics. According to the Japanese broadcast, 10,000 out of 80,000 Tokyo Olympics volunteers have quit due to the COVID-19 pandemic. You may ask me, what are my biggest takeaways from being a Tokyo Olympics volunteer? After working for 6 days, I get my Fieldcast gold badge. And most importantly, it's the friendship and the unforgettable experience here in Tokyo.